Hi everyone, I'm your Bajisa. Now I'd like to teach you the poem, The Wonderful Words. Dear students, this poem is composed by the poetess Mary O'Neill. And this poem is also prescribed for memorization. Dear students, now let's know something about the poetess Mary O'Neill. Mary O'Neill's full name was Mary Davenport O'Neill, who was an Irish poet and dramatist and a friend and a colleague of W.B. Yeats, George Russell and Austin Clark. She was born on 3rd August 1879, Barrack Street, Perth, Australia. The poetess died in the year 1967. Her spouse was Joseph O'Neill. And the poetess Mary O'Neill got her education from National College of Art and Design. Dear students, this is Mary O'Neill, a lady who you can see in the photo. And on her right side, the one photo you can see, it is her spouse, Joseph O'Neill. Okay, now let's move towards the poem by name, The Wonderful Words. This poem, The Wonderful Words, tells us the importance of English language in our day-to-day life. Dear students, let's see the poem. Never let a thought shrivel and die for want of a way to say it. For English is a wonderful game and all of you can play it. All that you do is match the words to the brightest thoughts in your head, so that they come out clear and true and handsomely groomed and fed. For many of the loveliest things have never yet been said. Words are the food and dress of thought. They give it its body and swing, and everyone is longing today to hear some fresh and beautiful thing. But only words can free a thought from its prison behind your eyes. Maybe your mind is holding now a marvelous new surprise. Okay, students. Now, let's try to discuss the poem from stanza to stanza in detail. Okay? The very first stanza is very interesting, easy to understand. And the poetess Mary O'Neill, how she starts the poem, let's see here. Never let a thought shrivel and die for want of a way to say it. She advises everyone in the world, the people in the world, readers of this world, not to allow a thought shrivel and die. Never let a thought, never allow a thought, never permit a thought shrivel and die for want of a way to say it. The poet's advice, salahe yenu tandra, for a want of a way to say it. It means namma talayalliruvanta vicharagalanna vyaktapadisalikke bekaguva language korateyinda nammalliruva vichara baadi saayalikke endu aaspada kodabedi. Never let means allow, parvanige needu, endu parvanige needabedi, edakke ಆ ಥಾಟ್ ವಿಚಾರಕ್ಕೆ, ಒಂದು ವಿಚಾರಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಸ್ರಿವೆಲ್ ಬಾಡಲಿಕ್ಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೈ ಸಾಯಲಿಕ್ಕೆ. ಯಾವುದರಿಂದ? ಫಾರ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ವೇ ಟು ಸೇ ಇಟ್. ವಾಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಅ ವೇ, ವೇಯ ಕೊರತೆಯಿಂದ. ಟು ಸೇ ಇಟ್, ಅದನ್ನು ವ್ಯಕ್ತಪಡಿಸಲು ಬೇಕಾಗದ ಒಂದು ಮಾರ್ಗದ ಕೊರತೆಯಿಂದ. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ಭಾಷಾ ಕೊರತೆಯಿಂದ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿರುವ ವಿಚಾರವು ಬಾಡಿ ಸಾಯಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಎಂದು ನಾವುಗಳು ಆಸ್ಪದ ಕೊಡಬಾರದು. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೋಯೆಟ್ ಮೇರಿ ಓ'ನೀಲ್ಸ್ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟನ್. ವೈ? ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಗೇಮ್. ಸಿ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಒನ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟನ್ ಟು ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಸಿ ಸೈಸ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್ ಗೇಮ್. ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಭಾಷೆ ಒಂದು ಅದ್ಭುತವಾದಂಥ ಆಟ. ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಪೋಯಿಟಿಸ್ ಮೇರಿ ಓ'ನೀಲ್, ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ಸಿ ಸೈಸ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಈಸ್ ಅ ಗೇಮ್. ಗೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಂಟರ್ಟೈನ್ಮೆಂಟ್. ಗೇಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಂಟ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್. ಎನಿ ಒನ್ ಕನ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಇಟ್. ಎನಿ ಒನ್ ಕನ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಇಟ್ ಟು ಪ್ಲೇ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡೀಸ್ ಅಸೆಟ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಯು ಕನ್ ಪ್ಲೇ ಇಟ್. ನೀವೆಲ್ಲರೂ ಈ ಆಟವನ್ನು ಆಡಬಹುದು. ವಿಚ್ ಗೇಮ್? ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಕನ್ ಪ್ಲೇ. ದ ಗೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ಲೇಡ್ ಬೈ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್. ಚಿಲ್ಡ್ರನ್, ಯೂತ್ಸ್, ಓಲ್ಡ್ ಏಜ್ ಪೀಪಲ್, ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಕನ್ ಪ್ಲೇ ದಿಸ್ ಗೇಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್? ಸಿ, ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್. ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಟಾಸ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಒನ್ ಟು ಲರ್ನ್. ಒನ್ ಶುಡ್ ಲರ್ನ್ ಅ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಅಸ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಅಸ್ ಹೀ ಆರ್ ಸಿ ಲರ್ನ್ಸ್ ಅ ಗೇಮ್. One should learn a language as interestingly as one learns a game to play. Therefore, English is a universal language. You know it. English is a window on the world. If you come to know English, you can understand the whole world. So, according to the poet, English is a wonderful game, the game which can be played by everyone. It can be enjoyed by everyone. Right? ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬರೂ ಈ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಆಟವನ್ನು ಆಡಬಹುದು. ಯಾಕೆ? ಇದೊಂದು ಸುಲಭದ ಆಟ, ಅದ್ಭುತವಾದ ಆಟ. ಭಾಷೆ ಅನ್ನುವುದು ಒಂದು ಆಟ, ಅದ್ಭುತವಾದ ಆಟ, ಸುಂದರವಾದ ಆಟ. ಈ ಆಟವನ್ನು ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬರೂ ಆಡಬಹುದು. ಬೈ ಪ್ಲೇಯಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಗೇಮ್, ಯು ನೋ, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ನೆವರ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಅವರ್ ಥಾಟ್ ಸ್ರಿವಲ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಡೈ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ದಿಸ್ ಗೇಮ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಪ್ಲೇ, ಈ ಭಾಷೆ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ಆಟವನ್ನು ಹೇಗೆ ಆಡಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನುವಂಥದ್ದು ಒಬ್ಬ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ದರೆ, ಆ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯಲ್ಲಿರುವಂಥ ವಿಚಾರಗಳು, ಭಾವನೆಗಳು, ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಯಾವೂ ಸಾಯೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಅವು ಕಣ್ಮರೆ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಪೋಯಿಟ್ ಮೇರಿ ಓ'ನೀಲ್ಸ್ ಐಡಿಯಾ. ಇನ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟಾಂಜಾ ದ ಪೋಯಿಟಿಸ್ ಮೇರಿ ಓ'ನೀಲ್ಸ್ ಸೇಸ್, ಆಲ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಡೂ ಈಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಬ್ರೈಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಹೆಡ್. Poetess Mary O'Neill suggests to the people of this world how to play this game of English, how to learn this language. She says, all that you do, ನೀವೇನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ, ಈ ಭಾಷೆಯನ್ನು ಕಲೀಲಿಕ್ಕೆ. Everyone wants to learn English. Everyone wants to learn English as a passion. Understand? See, For personal life, they may know their mother tongue, but for professional life, they have to learn this language. Many non-speaking countries, even today, they long to learn this language. But how to learn this language? How to learn this language? One golden rule is suggested by the poetess Mary O'Neill in this poem. How? See here. All that you do is, ನೀವೆಲ್ಲ ಏನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ, ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಟು ದ ಬ್ರೈಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹೆಡ್. ದ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹೆಡ್. ವಾಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್? ಬ್ರೈಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್, ಬ್ರೈಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್, ಗುಡ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್, ಟ್ಯಾಲೆಂಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್, ಇಂಟೆಲಿಜೆಂಟ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್, ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್, ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಹೆಡ್. ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ವಿಚಾರಗಳು, ಸುಂದರ ವಿಚಾರಗಳು ಇವೆ. ಆ ವಿಚಾರಗಳೊಂದಿಗೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರುವಂಥ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಪದಗಳನ್ನು ಜೋಡಿಸಲಿ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ನೋ ಆರ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಲರ್ನ್ ಹೌ ಟು ಮ್ಯಾಚ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಹೆಡ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಲರ್ನ್ಡ್ ಅ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. If you learn how to match the words to the thoughts, it's enough. You can speak a language. You can write a language. You need not say that, I don't know this language. How can I express my ideas with this language? Speaking language is very easy according to the poet. If you learn to match the words to the thoughts, enough, over. This we have to learn. This we have to teach to our students. The same thing happens whatever language we speak, however beautifully we speak, that all depends upon the learner's capacity of matching the words with his thoughts. If you learn to match the words to the thoughts in your head, what happens? If you match the right word to the right thought, right? So that the ideas or the thoughts come out clearly. They come out clearly. They come out truly. They come out handsomely groomed and fed. They come out handsomely means they will come out beautifully. They will come out healthily. If the ideas are matched rightly with the words, they will be spoken clearly, truly, beautifully, effectively, and healthily, so that people will feel happy to listen to your language. How effectively we speak, how beautifully we speak, depends upon how best we can match the words to the thoughts. Understand? A person who knows well to match the words to the right thoughts will become a good speaker. A person who is weak in matching the words to the right thoughts will be weak in speaker. That's it. It's a everyday process, continuous process. If we keep this process continuously growing, developing, enriching, one day we'll become the wonderful speaker. For many of the loveliest things have never yet been said. The poetess said that there are so many books, thousands and thousands of books have been brought out by hundreds of the writers. millions of thoughts have been expressed by thousands of people. But still there are thousands and thousands of beautiful ideas can be expressed if you know how to match the words with your thoughts. Your head is the source of ideas. Your head is the source of thoughts. Your head is the source of feelings. If you learn to match the words, beautiful words, with your beautiful thoughts, wonderful thoughts, rich thoughts, the rich ideas, beautiful ideas, effective ideas will come out clearly, truly, beautifully, healthily, so that everyone will feel pleasure to listen to your beautiful language, beautiful ideas. Beautiful ideas, beautiful speech will become when you use beautiful words for beautiful ideas. If you match ugly words to ugly thoughts, it will become ugly speech. If the idea is ugly, you have to match ugly words to it. If the idea is beautiful, you have to match beautiful words to beautiful thought. If the idea is poor, the words are poor. Okay? Bad idea, bad words. Good idea, good words. Rich idea, rich thought should be expressed with rich words. So, it's a kind of game. And we are all players. We should know how to play the game of English. We are playing this game with words. What are the instruments for us to play with? Here the words are the instruments to play with. Right? Please remember, for Ekendre, many of the loveliest things, even today, loveliest means beautiful things. Saviraru sundaravada vastugalu, vicharagalu have never yet been said. Innu hele illa prapanchadolaga. The poetess Mary O'Neill says, thousands and thousands of books written by hundreds of books. Millions of thoughts have been expressed by thousands of people. But still, many beautiful things have never yet been said. Innu aneka sundaravada vicharagalanna yaru hele illa. Such beautiful things, such rich things, such thought-provoking ideas, such heart-touching ideas you can express. By matching your ideas with the beautiful words, then be a beautiful player. Be a perfect player. Understand? Perfect player of a language. Here you have to play with the words. Understand? You have to know how to use the words to reach your goal, to express your ideas, to express your feelings, to express your thoughts effectively, beautifully, richly, truly, so that the listeners should feel happy to listen to you. Okay, let's move to the next point. The poet says in the next stanza, very beautiful stanza, third stanza, words are the food and dress of thought. They give it its body and swing. And everyone is longing today to hear some fresh and beautiful thing. Wow. Very quotable sentence. This is a quotable, memorable sentence the poetess Mary O'Neill uses in this stanza. The first line, very effective word, likable word. What does he say here? What does he say? Words are the food and dress of thought. Thoughts are there in our head. ವಿಚಾರಗಳು ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿರ್ತವೆ. ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಬ್ಬನ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಚಾರಗಳು ಬರ್ತವೆ, ಭಾವನೆಗಳು ಬರ್ತವೆ, ಕಲ್ಪನೆಗಳು ಬರ್ತವೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುವಂಥ ಕಲ್ಪನೆಗೆ, ಒಂದು ವಿಚಾರಕ್ಕೆ, ಪರಿಕಲ್ಪನೆಗೆ, ಆಹಾರ ಮತ್ತು ಡ್ರೆಸ್ ಯಾವುದು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ಗಳು. It means words give life to our thought. Words will give beauty to thought. Shabdagale vicharakke jeeva mattu aakara koduvantavugalu. Words are the food, words are the life, words are the dress of thought. Ondu vicharakke ಜೀವ ಮತ್ತು ಆಕಾರ ಬರಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಸಾಧನ ಶಬ್ದಗಳು. ಥಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೇಫ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್. ಸಿ, ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್? ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಫುಡ್. ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್? ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ದ ಡ್ರೆಸ್. ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ವಂಡರ್ಫುಲ್. ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ದ ಪವರ್. They have the power of giving life and body to our thought. However beautiful idea you may have, however effective idea a person may have, however rich ideas a person may have. Understand? If there is no language, his ideas, his feelings, his thoughts have no value. That's why our ideas are valued when there is a language, when there are words. So, words are the life givers, body givers to the thoughts. Yes, ನಿಮ್ಮ ವಿಚಾರ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಭಾವ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅದ್ಭುತವಾಗಿದೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ತಿಳಿಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅದ್ಭುತವಾದ ಭಾಷೆ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಮಾತ್ರ. Come on, a wonderful speaker will become wonderful because of language. World famous speaker will become world famous because of his world famous language. Understand? Not his thoughts will get valued, become popular because of language. Here, that's why the poet says wonderful words. ಶಬ್ದಗಳೇ ಅದ್ಭುತ, ಭಾಷೆಯೇ ಅದ್ಭುತ. ಹಿಯರ್ ಒಬ್ಬ ಮನುಷ್ಯನ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿತ್ವಕ್ಕೆ ಬೆಲೆ ಬರಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದು ಭಾಷೆಯಿಂದಲೇ ಸಾಧ್ಯ. ಒಬ್ಬ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಅ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ಸ್ ಯು ನೋ ವಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಹೀಸ್ ಪರ್ಸ್ನಾಲಿಟಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಹೀಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ವಾಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಹೀ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ಸ್, what kind of words he uses, right? Accordingly, we judge his personality. That's why we see here, the words that we speak reflect our inner strengths or one's own personality. Just by listening to one's language, one can understand his inner strengths, his own personality, what kind of person he is, what kind of strengths he has got. We can judge just by listening to his words. See, right? What happens? Words give it. It means thought. ಭಾಷೆ ಶಬ್ದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಕೊಡ್ತದೆ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ವಿಂಗ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಗಿವ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ಬಾಡಿ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಗಿವ್ ದ ಥಾಟ್ ಅ ಬಾಡಿ ವಾಟ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಮೇಕ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಥಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗಿವ್ ಅಗ್ಲಿ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ thought will become black. If you give average words to a thought, the thought will become average. Right? If you give rich words to average thought, that thought will be very effective. Please remember, a person who can speak a beautiful language, even though he has got average thoughts, he will become successful. A person who has got beautiful thoughts, but if he doesn't know how to match the words with his beautiful thoughts, he will become average person, average speaker. That's why a person who knows language very well, he will become successful. The poetess says, the words give it its body. Shabdagalu vicharakke ಆಕಾರ ಕೊಡುತ್ತವೆ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಗಿವ್ ಸ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಸ್ವಿಂಗ್ ಡು ಯು ನೋ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಜೋಕಾಲಜಿ ಸಿ ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ರಿಚ್ ಥಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ರಿಚ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬೈ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಥಾಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ಲೇ ಅ ರೋಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಪೆಂಡ್ಯುಲಮ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಟೂ ಹಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್ Language is just like a pendulum between two hearts. A language is just like a way between two hearts. Understand? It takes something from one heart and moves and passes the message to the other heart. Language is like a pendulum between two hearts. It escalates between two hearts. Do you know? It takes something from one and passes the same to other heart. Language is like a bridge between two hearts, two persons. So, who will travel on that bridge? Language travels. Language travels. It takes some feelings, thoughts, ideas from one person and the same thing will go to other person. What is the media here? Language is media. Media of what? Media of communication. Yeah. And the poet says, when everyone is longing today to hear some fresh and beautiful thing. Everyone is longing. Pratyabbaru hambalista iddare. Long here, humble is so, desire. Why? To hear some fresh and beautiful thing. People in the world are always ready to listen some fresh and beautiful thing. They want new things. They want fresh things. They want beautiful things. They like to listen beautiful things. They want to listen new things. They are always ready. Jana hosadanna kelike sundaravadadanna kelike yavagalu hambalistana irthare. If you tell the people the same thing again and again, they lose interest. They don't show interest in listening to you. But every time, if you go with new ideas, if you go with beautiful ideas, you will have the same number of audience, the same zeal in audience, the same interest in audience, you can see. That's why we have to keep in mind people in the world are always ready to listen new ideas and beautiful ideas. They never hesitate to listen. Jana yavagalu hosadanna sundaravagiruvantadanna kelike yavagalu siddha irtare. Hosadirbeku sundaravagirbeku. It must be new and beautiful. Though the thing is new, if it is ugly, people won't listen to it. People shun it. Jana shapistare. Hosadiddu kurupiyagidre, kettaddagidre vichara, adan kelike ishtapadodilla. Hosadirbek, sundaravagirbeku. It must be positive. It must be constructive. It must be beautiful. Right? This is what the poetess Mary O'Neill advises. Okay, dear students. But only words can free our thoughts. The last stanza, very beautiful lines. The poet composes here. But only words can free a thought from its prison behind your eyes. Maybe your mind is holding now a marvelous new surprise. The poetess Mary O'Neill says in the last stanza, what? She says, only, kevala shabdagalu. Only words, words means a language, can free a thought. Only words can free a thought from its prison behind your eyes. Poet says, kevala shabdagalu nimma kannina hindiruva jailininda shabdagalanna swari vicharagalanna bhavanegalanna bidugade maduvanta shaktiyannu hondive. Words are the key to free your thought from the prison of your head. See, man is full of thoughts. Man is full of feelings. Man is full of ideas. So, if he knows a language to speak, then all his ideas will come out. They will be released. They will be freed. Man will become relaxed. Right? Shabdagalu matra nama kannugala hindiruva eno manasinalli esto bhavagalirtave, esto vicharagalirtave, esto ideas irtave. Avellavagalu horag barbeku antandre adakke source bekala. ದಾರಿ ಬೇಕಲ್ಲ. ಆ ದಾರಿ ಯಾವುದು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಭಾಷೆ. ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಔಟ್. ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಔಟ್. ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಔಟ್. ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಫಾರ್ ಅವರ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಔಟ್. ನಮ್ಮ ಐಡಿಯಾಸು, ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ಸು, ಥಾಟ್ಸು ಎಲ್ಲವೂ ಹೊರಗೆ ಹೋಗಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಗೌಲ್ಡನ್ ವೇ, ಗೌಲ್ಡನ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಯಾವುದು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದುವೇ ಭಾಷೆ. ಶಬ್ದಗಳು ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸನ್ನು ಹಗುರುಗೊಳಿಸ್ತವೆ. ಭಾಷೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸನ್ನು ಹಗುರುಗೊಳಿಸ್ತದೆ. ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿರುವ, ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂಧನಕ್ಕೊಳಗಾಗಿರುವಂಥ ವಿಚಾರಗಳು ಹೊರಗೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಶಬ್ದಗಳ ಸಹಾಯ ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಅ ಥಾಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಸನ್. ವೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಸನ್? ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಐಸ್, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಚಕ್ಷುಗಳ ಹಿಂದೆ, ಕಣ್ಣುಗಳ ಹಿಂದೆ, ಆಂಖೇಕ್ಕೆ ಪೀಚೆ ಏನು ತಲೆ ಇದೆ, ಮೈಂಡ್ ಇದೆ, ಆ ಮೈಂಡ್ನಲ್ಲಿರುವಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಚಾರಗಳು ಫ್ರೀ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ಹೊರಗೆ ಹೋಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಕಾರಣ ಶಬ್ದಗಳು. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸಿಂಪ್ಲಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ ಅ ಗುಡ್ ಪ್ಲೇಯರ್, ಒಬ್ಬ ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ಆಟಗಾರ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ರೆ, ಭಾಷಾ ಆಟಗಾರ ಭಾಷೆಯನ್ನು ಆಡುವಂಥ ಶಬ್ದಗಳನ್ನು ಆಡುವಂಥ ಆಟಗಾರ ಶಬ್ದಗಳೊಂದಿಗೆ ಆಡುವಂಥ ಆಟಗಾರ ನಾವಾಗಿಬಿಟ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂಧನಕ್ಕೊಳಗಾಗಿರುವಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲ ಆದರ್ಶಗಳನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲ ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಭಾವಗಳನ್ನು ನಾವು ಆರಾಮ್ಸೆ ಸುಂದರವಾಗಿ ಹೊರಹಾಕ್ಬೋದು. ಶಬ್ದಗಳಿಗೆ ಮಾತ್ರ ನಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯನ್ನು ಹಗುರು ಮಾಡುವಂಥ ಸಾಮರ್ಥ್ಯ ಇದೆ. ಓನ್ಲಿ ವರ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ದ ಪವರ್ ಟು ಗಿವ್ ರಿಲೀಫ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ಟು ಗಿವ್ ರಿಲ್ಯಾಕ್ಸೇಷನ್ ಟು ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ಟು ಫ್ರೀ ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್, ಟು ಫ್ರೀ ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಐಡಿಯಾಸ್, ಟು ಫ್ರೀ ಅವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಪೆಂಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನಾವ್ ಸಿ ಒನ್ ಫೋಟೋ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಹಿಯರ್. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೈಂಡ್, ಬ್ರೈನ್. ಸಿ ಇನ್ಸೈಡ್ ದ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಅ ಬೇಬಿ ಈಸ್ ಪೀಪಿಂಗ್, ಬೇಬಿ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್. Here, baby is just like thought. From our mind, thoughts are always trying to come out. Here, eye is there. Behind our eye, thought is trying to come out. See, for our ideas, for our thoughts, for our feelings, which are always trying to come out in our mind, in our head, they need one language. They need words. They are the keys. Words are the keys to free the ideas, feelings, and thoughts from our head. They make the way, beautiful way, for the ideas to come out. Right? Now, at last, the poetess Mary O'Neill says, maybe, irubodu, maybe your mind, bausha nimma manasu iga, is holding now. ಹಿಡ್ಕೊಂಡಿರಬಹುದು ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸು ಈಗ, ಬಹುಶಃ ಹಿಡಿದುಕೊಂಡಿರಬಹುದು ಏನನ್ನ? ಮಾವಲಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್. ಮಾವಲಸ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಅ ಬ್ಯೂಟಿಫುಲ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್, ನ್ಯೂ ಥಾಟ್. ಮೇ ಬಿ ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೋಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ನಾವ್ ಅ ಮಾವಲಸ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಸರ್ಪ್ರೈಸ್. ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸು ಅದ್ಭುತವಾದ ಒಂದು ವಿಚಾರವನ್ನು ಹಿಡಿದುಕೊಂಡಿರಬಹುದು. ನಾವ್ ಯು ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಟ್ರೈ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಔಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್. ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಲೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂಥದ್ದೊಂದು ಅದ್ಭುತ ವಿಚಾರ ಈಗ ಬಂದಿದ್ದರೆ ದಯವಿಟ್ಟು ಮಾತನಾಡಿಬಿಡಿ. ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಗೇಮ್, ವಿತ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್. ನೆವರ್ ಹೆಜಿಟೇಟ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ದ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಯು ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ ಇಟ್. You speak to pass your ideas. You speak English to pass your feelings. You speak English to pass your thoughts. First, you try to pass the matter, and then comes manner. Never worry about manner. Never worry about the mistakes. According to the poet, it is just like a game. You are all players. You learn only one thing. That is, you please match the right word to the right thought. Enough, and try to speak up. You will become a perfect speaker. You will become a perfect player of English game. You will be appreciated by all. Understand, dear students. Never hesitate to play this game. It's a wonderful game. It's a beautiful game. What is the name of this game? English language. Got it? Okay, friends. At last, I would like to say, please read this poem. Listen to this video again and again. I hope you came to know something about this poem. If this video has helped you in understanding the poem, the wonderful words, please don't forget to like it, don't forget to share it with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't so far. And with one more very useful and interesting video, I'd like to see you all next time. Till then, bye.